Hi everyone, I am happy to give the presentation on lecture 11, that is effect of addition of a pole and zero on the system performance. We have already seen in the last presentation how to construct root locus technique. This presentation will be able to facilitate the learners to understand the root locus technique still better. Further, they will be able to apply the root locus for improving the performance of complex systems. The objectives of the presentation are to analyze the effect of adding a pole to the system, effect of adding a zero to the system, then to employ root locus as an effective tool for the analysis. First, let us consider the root locus of a given system. This is a system which has got only two poles. So we know very well that the root loci, there will be only two root loci because there are two poles. They break away and one goes like this and another root locus goes like this. Therefore, this system is stable. Let us understand what will happen to the system behavior when a zero or pole is added. So this is the root locus of the given system which I have shown in the previous slide. Now I have added one pole. So let us see what will happen because of this. Since I have added a pole, what happens is, see, whenever you have two poles in between any test point, if you take to the right, you have only one pole, there is nothing else. So this is a root locus segment. Similarly, you have another pole to the left. If you take, there are three poles. So this is a root locus segment. Totally, there are three root locus segments because there are three open loop poles. Therefore, root locus starting from this pole and root locus starting from this pole, they meet and break away. One goes like this, another goes like this. Both become complex and they cut the J omega axis. After a particular gain, both become unstable. That means both travel in the right of a west plane, whereas the third closed loop pole goes like this. So the system which was originally stable has become unstable. Therefore, when you add a pole to the system, stability of the system is affected. So this is an important observation. Same system, a zero is added to the left. Already two poles are there like this. Now I have added a zero to this. Let us see what will happen to the system performance. Again, when you apply the root locus rules, we know that you have a root locus segment here. Similarly, here you have a root locus segment. So root locus starting from this pole and root locus starting from this pole, actually they travel in the opposite direction. So they travel in the opposite direction and they meet at this particular point and then they break away. So one goes like this, another goes like this. Again they meet here, break away, one goes to the zero, another goes to this. Why the root locus is like this? Because there are only two root loci. Among the two root loci, one has to terminate at open loop zero. Therefore, remaining one will terminate here only, because angle of asymptotes rule, if you apply, it is plus or minus 2q plus 1 into 180 degree by n minus m. So 2 minus 1, 1. So q take the value only 0. Therefore, angle of asymptote is 180. Therefore, asymptote will be here, that is towards the negative real axis. So therefore, one goes like this, another goes like this. So what has happened here is, finally one pole has reached this open loop zero, another pole, closed loop pole, has reached the negative infinity. That means the system stability has improved. Not only that, since the poles have become more negative real and finally this zero is here, which is definitely more negative than this, and more negative than this combination, definitely the transient response has also improved, because transient response finally settling time depends on zeta omega, and therefore real part of the dominant root has become more here. Therefore system has become, system has settled down faster. Therefore the stability as well as transient response have improved. Here also a zero is added to the same system, but zero is inserted in between the two poles. Let us investigate the root locus. So here one root locus definitely has to terminate on this, because to the right there is only one pole. So according to the root locus rule, this terminates here. Here this has to go here, because to the right there are three, that is odd number. Therefore one root locus goes like this, another goes like this. Definitely this is dominant, and this I can say based on this position, this position zero, if the zero is closer to this pole, and if this point is slightly, in between, or if this point is towards this pole, probably I can say stability is not affected, but the transient response in this case will be more. That is, if this is closer to this pole and if the zero is closer to this pole. Otherwise addition of a zero has not produced any significant effect on the system response. Now a zero is added to the right side of the rightmost pole. Let us investigate the root locus. So now this root locus goes like this, this root locus goes like this. Why they go like this? Because of that rule 3, that is, to the right there is an odd number of zero, here to the right the even number of, odd number of poles and zeros, here you have even number, so no root locus. So here again system stability is not affected, however the transient response is affected. Why it is affected? Because here the complex root loci, they have the constant negative real part, that is this value, which is almost in between this. Now that value is shifted to this place, therefore it has become less negative, meaning that the transient response is slightly poor, that is settling time is slightly higher. Similarly stability also more closer to the j omega axis. So consolidation of all these things, that is, this is the system, a pole is added, system has become unstable, zero is added, so here, so transient response has improved, stability has also improved. So here zero is added in between the poles, so based on this position I can say whether the transient response or stability are little bit affected. Here stability as well as transient response are affected, in the sense that the relative stability is affected and the transient response, it has slowed down, settling time has become more. However, when you add zero, definitely stability is not affected by making the system unstable. Let us see an unstable system first. Earlier we have seen stable system. Now let us see unstable system. Now there are three poles. Now I add one more pole to the system. So it may be to the left. So when you have four poles, no zeros, means that means when you calculate the angle of asymptotes, angle of asymptotes is 2q plus 180 degree divided by 4. Q takes the value 0, 1, 2, 3. So you'll have 45 degree asymptote, 135 degree asymptote, 225 degree asymptote, 315 degree asymptote. I think we have seen such a problem with the four poles in as a problem 3 in lecture 10. So if we introspect the other rules, that is, this should be a root locus segment on real axis, this should be a root locus segment on the real axis, because any tile point if you take to the right hand side, you have 1, 2, 3 odd numbers. Similarly any point if you take one pole, so odd number, in between if you take here, even numbers, so no root locus. Therefore, root locus starting from here and starting from here, they have to meet and break away, and they have to follow this asymptote and this asymptote. Similarly, root locus starting from here so it will travel in this direction. Similarly, root locus starting from here, it will travel in this direction. So they meet here. And they break away, one following this asymptote, another following this asymptote. Therefore, already the system is stable, unstable, still the system is unstable. That means, in an unstable system, when you add a pole, it will again make the system unstable only. Same unstable system, but I have placed a zero, an open loop zero, to the right hand side of the rightmost open loop pole. Let us see the effect. So here we can see, by application of proper rules, this will, that is rule 3, this will terminate here. Root locus starting from here and root locus starting from here, they have to meet and break away. Since there are 3 poles and 1 0, definitely there are 2 asymptotes, 90 degree and 270 degree. Exact position of poles and zeros, if we know, exact value of the centroid we know. So let us assume that these 2 are the asymptotes drawn approximately. So these 2 meet, let us say they meet and break away like this. Even they can meet somewhere here and break away like this also. Anyway, for the purpose of understanding, I have taken breakaway point somewhere here. That means, this dominant root locus is here, and these 2 root loci have become more stable. That means, overall, no root locus is in the right hand side of the S plane. Therefore, stability of the system has improved. Not only that, transient response has also improved, because the real part is more negative. The dominant part, real part, is worst case is this position, that is open loop zero position, when k equal to infinity. So addition of a zero to an unstable system has improved the transient response as well as stability. Now I have added a zero somewhere here in between. Let us see what happens. So here again, the root locus starting from this pole terminates here. Root locus starting from here and starting from here, they meet and break away like this. They follow the asymptotes. Why the asymptotes are 90 degree and 270 degree? Because there are three root loci, one open loop zero. Therefore, 2 asymptotes only. So 3 minus 1, 2 means 90 degree, 270 degree. So one root locus goes like this, another root locus goes like this after breaking away from here. Therefore, if we compare this with this configuration, here, this root locus, this is the dominant root locus. Therefore, stability is more and the transient response is also better. That means, compared to the previous addition of 0, this addition of 0 has still improved the stability and the transient response. Now, consolidating all these observations, that is effect of, this is the system, effect of adding a pole to the system, this is effect of adding a 0 to the system, this is effect of adding a 0 to the system. So, what we can understand from these 3 is, so here the system stability is affected, unstable system has become still unstable. Here the unstable system has become stable and the transient response is also improved. Here the unstable system has become stable, transient response is improved. But comparing these 2, this is slightly, poor compared to this. That is, this is better than this performance in terms of stability as well as transient response. But in both the cases, stability is definitely ensured compared to this. Suppose we consider the root locus of a system like this, that is, we have a 2 pole and a 0. We know this will be the root locus. Now let us see what will happen. So I have added a pole to the left of this. Already we have poles and zeros. A pole is added to the left. So when you add a pole to the left, what happens is, by that rule 3, this is a root locus segment, this is a root locus segment. It means root locus starting from this open loop pole terminates on open loop 0. Root rows starting from this and this, they travel in opposite direction, meet and break away. Of course, asymptotes 90 degree, 270 degree, because there are only two root loci which are going to terminate because of the presence of an open loop 0. Therefore, these two root loci are the dominant root loci compared to this root locus. So here what happens is, since this is placed to the left, we can see here the dominant root locus finally is here. Another root locus goes here like this. Whereas here what happens is, there were only two root loci because only two poles. Now I am adding one pole, so three root loci. Further, what happens is, these two are the dominant root loci. Here this is the dominant root locus. Definitely this real part is more negative, because this is here, more negative than this. Therefore, here stability has come down, not unstable, but stability has reduced. Transient response also got reduced. So generally adding a pole will decrease the stability. It will also decrease the transient response. Here the pole is added at the origin, almost rightmost to this. So what is the effect? So here we can see the root locus starting from here terminates here. Root loci starting from these two, one goes like this, one goes like this. Therefore, the dominant root loci are very closer to the JMA axis. Suppose the breakaway point is somewhere here, asymptote is somewhere here, means probably it will travel in the right hand side of S plane also. Therefore, stability is very much affected, the transient response is also affected. So generally, whenever you add a pole to a system which is already stable, it will affect the stability as well as transient response. Suppose I add a 0 to the system. Already 1 0 and 2 poles. I have added 1 0 to the left. Let us see what happens. So here, root loci starting from these two, they meet and break away. They meet and break away. Here again they meet and break away. So two breakaway points. One goes like this, another goes like this. That means this is going to be the dominant root locus. Almost very much similar to this. So transient response is also not affected, stability is also not affected appreciably. So effect of adding a 0 to the system has not done any appreciable effect in this particular case. Now 0 is added at the origin. So what happens? So one root locus goes like this, another root locus goes like this. Therefore stability is affected. Anyway, it is not becoming unstable. Since it is dominant root locus is like this, definitely this is less negative than this dominant root locus. Therefore, transient response is also affected. So if you add a 0 to the right hand side of the rightmost polar 0, generally it will decrease the stability as well as transient response if the system is already stable and already doing better transient response. Right, now I have added one more 0. So here 0 is added between these two poles. So 0 is added between these two poles. So therefore, what is its effect? So root locus starting from here terminates on this. Root locus starting from this terminates on this. Therefore, finally, this is going to be the dominant root locus. Here, this is the dominant root locus. So, transient response is not very much uh, affected, probably we can say because of here we had a zero here. Since we have zero slightly here, there is a slight reduction in the transient because this is less negative compared to this. So transient response and stability, I can say relative stability, are little bit affected. So consolidating all these observations, so already system is stable and is giving good transient response because of the presence of zero. So when I add pole to the system, stability has come down, transient response also come down. Here when I have added pole to the system, stability is worst affected. So therefore no need to talk about the transient response. When you add a zero to the system, so here there is no much effect on the transient response or stability. Here relative stability has come down, transient response has also come down. So here transient response has little bit got affected, similarly the stability. Therefore, when we consolidate the observations of all these three systems, that is, we have considered three systems. Initially, we considered a system with only two poles. Then we considered a system with three poles. Then now we have considered a system with two poles and zero. So in all the cases, what did we understand by adding a pole or zero to the system? So that we can consolidate. Generally, when you add a pole to a stable system, it will affect its stability. That we have seen very clearly. When you add a zero to an unstable system, it will improve its stability. That we have seen in the second case very well. Generally, adding a zero will affect or improve the transient response depending upon the position of placing the zero. That is what we have seen in the third system. So generally, when you have poles only in the system, if we add further pole, it will decrease the stability. When you already have a zero in the system, if we add a zero, it will further improve the transient response. And when you don't have a zero in an unstable system, when you add a zero, it will improve stability as well as transient response. So generally, adding a zero is a better choice compared to adding a pole whenever we are interested in improving the stability as well as transient response. Thank you.